ready to rock as well. Some of the stars of today's game. And speaking of the game, let's get right to it. On to get us started now, the kicker, Chris Boswell. And we are underway from the City Beautiful. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he'd taken a knee, as he'll start at the 21-yard line. They come out here in the eye. On first down, it's Palmer. And this one complete to Martellus Bennett. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height. Sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there. He's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll bring up a third down.
Hey, the defense is in this game as well. They wanted to make it a tough third down. They were able to do so on that last play, preventing a big game.
On third down, Palmer. Got a man. He finds Sanders. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
So how do you beat man coverage? First of all, you want to be a superior receiver, but you know something, that guy who's covering you, he's usually pretty good too, so the corner route is usually a great spot to get it done.
Right now, blue 58, blue 58.
Throwing now, Palmer on first down. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Larry Fitzgerald was the intended target. That'll bring up second down.
But that's the type of pass play that you need to wait for routes to develop. You need a little time in the pocket. But that's hard to do when you got people in your face.
Get ready. Deep. Deep.
They'll send the tight end Bennett in motion.
Mirror, mirror, mirror.
Second and 10 now. It's Palmer. And he's going to go down way back at the 42-yard line. And I know it seems like we say this a lot in broadcast booths, but a quarterback can hold on to the football too long in these situations. I think he did right there.
Oh, I agree with you totally. Sometimes you have to understand situations. Get rid of the football, save some yardage, to make it less to gain for the next down. Instead, he was so hipped on ball security, he held on to it and took a big sack.
Third and long. Trying to get it to Thomas, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line.
Well, Brandon, there's no question who they're going to look to on third and long, but you can bet this defense knows that as well, so they get him blanketed downfield. And this ball winds up being intercepted.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. And he's going to be stepped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
Let's go!
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Give him credit for batting it away, but unable to come up with the interception. And sometimes that joke does come true. Guys are on defense for a reason. Maybe their hands aren't quite as skillful as the guys on offense, but without credit on that play for just knocking it away.
They'll set up a throw. It's complete. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even added a little extra at the end with a short run.
Time running out here on the play clock. Looking to throw. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
I've become a firm believer over the years that many drops happen before the ball's even snapped. When you call a wide receiver screen, as we saw there, I know these guys really well. They're thinking about that play going to the end zone, and sometimes they forget to catch the football first.
Let's go! Brad 38! Brad 38!
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. It's a pickup of 16 there to the lead to a new set of downs. For the offense lining up first and 10.
Let's go!
They'll give it to him right up the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. They'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
Red zone opportunity.
Here we go.
They'll give it to him right up the gun. And a loose football. The ball comes out. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis. It's the Cardinals in possession of the football, and they've got it here with a first down. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
Right now, 1-18.
They'll throw on first down here with Palmer. He gets it into the hands of Larry Fitzgerald. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
Well, there's the first time in this game that Carson Palmer finds Larry Fitzgerald. Likely won't be the last, but how about the way these two have helped each other's careers?
Yeah, it really has. It's hard to believe with Fitzgerald, but really both of these guys, how long they've been in the league now, but Fitzgerald, still looking at a pick back in 04.
Yeah, how about that? Remember, Carson Palmer, a former Heisman Trophy winner, he's finally found a real home in Arizona.
So what will they do on the ground through the air? Let's see. Second and 9.
Here we go. Blue 58.
They give it off here to the tight end. They'll wind up losing 3. And now it's third down. So now it's third and 12 with an extra defender here in the secondary. A nickel look. And it goes in motion here in the backfield. On third down, Palmer is going to find his running back. It's complete. Give him 8 on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears try to go for it on 4.
Deep. Let's go.
Fourth down. Here's Palmer. This is Johnson. He's got it. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35.
We always talk about big-time players make big-time plays in big-time moments. I think that fourth down qualified. That was a heck of a throw.
Fresh set of downs here. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Throwing now, Palmer on first down. Sanders has it over the middle. A gain of 6 there on first. And it looks like this will likely be the last play before we hit the 2-minute warning.
Let's see if they can sneak one more good play in before the 2-minute signal.
2 minutes remain in a scoreless first half. Back to more NFL action on EA Sports after this. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Palmer now. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. This will be the 8th play of the drive here. 3rd and 4. One receiver left, 3 to the right. Throwing again here, Palmer. And he's got Fitzgerald. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. The 13 yards that time at a first.
Anytime you call man coverage against Larry Fitzgerald, you're really holding your breath as a defensive guy, because his ability to run such precise routes and use that big frame that he has, that body against you, it's going to be very difficult to break passes up against him.
Yeah, when you make 9 Pro Bowls in your first 12 years, you might want to give him a little bit more coverage than that.
Yeah, it's not just athletic ability. He's a thinking man's receiver as well.
It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down.
Well, that play really didn't fool them. They completed the screen pass, but for lost yardage, a really nice play by the defense.
Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense.
Here we go.
The throw again, it's Palmer. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. He was trying to hit Thomas that time. And that takes us from 2nd to 3rd down.
It's not just the offensive lineman and the guys charged with protecting him to take it personally when the franchise quarterback is dropped on the ground. It runs through the whole organization, from the owner all the way down.
It's like every single time he goes down, everyone holds their breath.
Not only do they hold their breath, but they feel the hit as well. They're just trying to think of ways for
it. Trying to get it to Thomas, and it's intercepted. And he's got some space here. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. They were in the dime. They had 6 defensive backs there. So go ahead and throw it. He threw it, and it hurt him.
It's almost turned into a blanket of coverage, isn't it? You talk about the best defenders you have are the defensive backs. 6 of them on the field. You're almost asking for trouble, and that's exactly what they ran into. Ended up throwing a pick 6.
Yeah, 6 defenders and 6 points. Timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And following the pick 6, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick 6. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
They've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's 2nd down. 1 receiver left, 3 to the right. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Caught on the left side, Fitzgerald. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. They'll throw on first down here with Palmer. Collision there, jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down. Offense still needing 10 yards. 2nd down.
It's Gregler.
They'll send the tight end Bennett in motion. 2nd and 10. It's Palmer again. He's going to let this one go deep. And that's caught inside the 35. A very solid gain of 27.
Strength throwing the football downfield has never been an issue for this big guy. I still remember the first time I met him. He was playing for USC, and when I got introduced to him, I thought I was meeting their starting tight end, not their starting quarterback.
Such a presence. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Offense in a good spot here, second and two. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Again, it's Palmer. This throw to the six. And they do get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. And now they're in the hurry up.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half.
Get ready!
Final play of the half. It's Palmer. And that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock. So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the left hand, should be a fairly easy one here. And Vinatieri's kick is good. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Now this offense ready to take over again. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they're going a little bit deeper into their playbook. And like what they did in the first half, that worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that.
Here we go! Pass 38! Pass 38!
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He rifles one, it's intercepted. Picked off by Dayon Buchanan. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points.
And Johnson lost the football. It's loose, pumped out. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble. That could have been trouble.
All I can say about this play is that someone's living right. I mean, he's trying to gain yardage, trying to get upfield. Ball comes free. What's that panic that we've talked about oftentimes that you feel when you lose the ball?
You can sense it.
Oh, you can sense it. And somehow he got to it and was able to recover for a squad.
Now his throw is incomplete.
In most pass defenses, the guy playing safety has the ability to roam free and try and go to the football. But when you're in man, you've got to cover just like a guy playing out on the corner. Lock up on the receiver and go to the football. That's exactly what he did, batting that one away.
In danger of squandering their great field position as they come up on a third and seven.
1-18!
On third down, Palmer. And he's got Bennett. A gain of 11 and a first down.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do, and it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up in the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
Here's Johnson. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. He's fumbled already once, Charles. I'm not going to say that that was in his mind there, but I'm sure that during some of these plays, he is mindful of it.
And once you fumble the ball, you know what your team tells you and your coaching staff? take care of it, rest of the game. And that does get in your mind a little bit, and sometimes that slows down your effort in trying to get free from tackles.
And the defenders know it too. They sniff that out, don't they?
Everybody wants to swarm the football. You know the rule is, first guy hold up the runner, everyone else try and get there and strip the ball free.
They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Third and two, now Palmer. Now this one's intercepted. A third interception for Palmer. A great read, and it's picked off. And here now the offense heading back out there.
Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
And he's got to go down. He backed up into the end zone, and this is going to wind up a safety. And the blitz was on there, able to get in the backfield from the linebacker spot and get him 2 points.
Brandon, we know a defensive coordinator right now who's looking for a raise. He had that dialed in perfectly, didn't he? The perfect blitz at the perfect time, 2 points for his team.
This is taken at about the 14. The Cardinal offense now making their way back out onto the field. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, the number four's kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you...
And his pass is intercepted for the third time today. A great read, and it's picked off. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. And the last time they had the football, they surrendered 2 points on the safety. And they don't want to do that one again.
No, not at all. It's almost like a bases clearing double, isn't it? Give up a couple of runs. Just messes things up for you offensively. But now they've got to go ahead, take it, set it aside, and move forward.
Well, at least he was able to break that initial contact, or it could have been a loss.
Yeah, give credit to the defensive player, though. What did he do? Made him slow down, slow up his feet, and allow the rest of the guys to get there to finish him off.
Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. Picked off by Deion Sanders. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens.
Let's go.
So after the interception, here's Palmer. Sanders has it over the middle. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. And they're going to hurry back to the line now.
Let's go, let's go.
Now a play fake here on first down. Caught left side, Benner. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough. Swing the tight end free downfield for the conversion.
On second down, Johnson. And he is going to lose yardage here. They'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and they're going to face a third down.
Wasn't that long ago that the NFL guys really didn't adopt much from the college game? But one thing that has crept in there is spreading things out, opening things up, not even just in tempo, but maybe getting better line splits and spreading the field. I think that would be a great strategy right now to try to open things up in the run game.
From the gun on third down, it's Palmer. He sets to fire deep. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
That was a long pass attempt downfield, and the ball was popped up in the air. And how come things go from really fast to almost slow motion when the ball's up in the air and the defender's unable to haul it in before it hits the ground?
They'll break the huddle here and go for it. This is fourth down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Here we go.
Well, here we go on fourth down. Palmer. And now here's another interception. A great read, and it's picked off. The interception rolls. They just continue to mount. He's thrown 5 picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran the wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It can be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
Welcome back live to Orlando. It's been a good one so far. Just a two-point game here as we get set for quarter number four. And the offense behind the chains here, a touch on second and 11. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Deion Buchanan. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. And the Cardinals offense here ready to take over. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
Okay, let's face it. Most of the offensive linemen in today's NFL, they're going to weigh over 300 pounds. That doesn't mean they don't have agility. And the way that they can get out in front of a runner and create a space, sometimes it looks like they're going in one direction, and the runner uses his eyes to take him in another direction because he's been blocked so well. Love those misdirection and counter plays. And this one worked really well for a nice piece of yardage.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. They'll come out in the pistol.
Blue 58.
On second down, Palmer. First hit, fumble. He loses the football. So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defense is talking about. Getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That can be a little bit deflating. Exactly right. A lost opportunity.
He's going to go for it. And my goodness, another interception. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line. What a nightmarish game he's having now. Six interceptions that he has thrown.
Absolutely unbelievable, isn't it? Hard to believe we're watching this and have seen it. But it just tells you about the game of football. It give it, and it taketh away.
Yeah, the guys, though, that have thrown six interceptions in a game, the likes of Peyton Manning, Brett Favre, I think Joe Namath, he did it three times.
And that was well defended. And as a cornerback, what you're taught when you see a wide receiver screen, either you get underneath the play before the blocking forms, or you're going to have to fight your way through it by getting through some blocking. That was a really nice play there.
Play clock winding down. Back to throw. Wide open receiver complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. That one goes for 24 yards. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. And he'll give it here to his running back. And able to push his way forward. Now here's a timeout defensively coming from the Cardinals. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Here we go!
Now it looks like he'll throw here. Quickly here, and that's complete. Now the Cardinals going to use another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
They threw the screen to the perimeter, but to no benefit at all. Tackled behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of yardage.
The 25-yard line is what they need here. This is third down.
Let's go!
Now they'll throw here. Out of the gun. He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. And a gain there of 11 yards. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that,
lights go down and the week is here. Save my soul. I can feel the coming troubles in the air.